Hey YouTube, welcome to another bait ramp review. In this episode I'm going to have a look at the Port of Brisbane bait ramp, which is located right up at the mouth of the Brisbane River. For a first time user, I wouldn't say it's the easiest bait ramp to find your way to, but once you've been there once you won't have any problems. A few more signs on the road wouldn't go astray. They may have them by now. When I enter the bait ramp area, I turn left and take that left hand lane down in between the car park. And when I get there, I usually pull up along that left-hand side somewhere to prep the bait before I get on the ramp. And it's never been that busy that I've had any problem finding an area to do that. But there again, just bear in mind, I try not to be a weekend baity. I try to go out during the week when it's a lot quieter on the ramps. Now once you've got your bait all prepped, proceed down onto the ramp. And it is quite a good ramp with a nice steep, deep entry. Have no trouble launching a larger bait from here. The ramp has a pontoon to tie up on, which makes solo launch and retrieval very easy. On a ramp like this, I find it's pretty easy to tie the front and back ropes up onto the pontoon with just enough slack to let me launch the boat and then jump up on the pontoon, grab the rope, walk it out so that it's out of the way, tie it off properly, and jump back in my car and get it off the ramp. Depending on how busy it is and which way the wind's blowing, you can tie up on either side of the pontoon. There's plenty of water on both sides. Now every time I've been there, once the boat's in the water, there's never been a problem to find a car park. I just drive up and drive straight into the first one available. Your mileage may vary on weekends though. I'll just pan the camera around the general area of the ramp just to give you a bit of a look at the surroundings. Now I'd have to say that this isn't the nicest ramp that I use. Now this ramp area gives me a general feeling that it's run down and uncared for. You can see the cement's a bit cracked, everything's a little bit dirty. The fact that people come here, go fishing, come back, fillet their fish and scale them, and leave the guts and bones and scales just laying on the ground, gives it the feeling that no one really cares, and no one can be bothered to clean up after themselves. Most of the other ramps that I use are really pristine. They're either cleaned up or people just don't make a mess there. When a ramp's clean and well cared for, and in an area that sees a lot more traffic, it generally just gives me more confidence to leave my car there overnight. I don't think I'd be game to leave my car here overnight, although it doesn't seem to be much of a problem for a day's fishing. When you depart the ramp, you go out under the bridge, which takes you past the police boats, the barge, and an area where a lot of tugboats tie up. Now, given that you're going out right past where the police boats launch, make sure that you've got all your safety equipment on board and up to date. It would spoil the day if one of them happened to be coming out at the same time you were going past and just decided to stop you and check the safety equipment and found that it wasn't quite up to scratch. Quite apart from the fact that you should always keep your safety equipment up to scratch, because that safety equipment could be all that keeps you alive one day. When you come back in, tie up to the pontoon, go get your car, get your boat out of the water, and then I drive up along the left-hand side and pull up towards the end of it, provided there's no cars in there that I'm going to block, and prepare my bait for the road. Now there is toilet facilities there pointed to by this arrow, but just be aware they are unisex toilets, so if any of your crew have a problem with that, you might want to consider another ramp, or suggesting that that crew member might be better coming out on another trip. Now, where do I go when I launch from the Port of Brisbane? Well, to be honest, not very far. I go up towards the city a bit, and I go out towards the mouth of the river, but that's about it. There's lots of other ramps around that I like to launch from when I'm going to the places that I generally fish. This is just a ramp that I use on a fairly rare occasion. What about the boat passage that leads down to the south? Well, I can tell you from experience, I've explored that pretty thoroughly, and at low tide, I can't get my boat through there. If you watch the tide, you can probably get in and out of there all right. But I don't use it because if you miss the tide, you have to go all the way around to the river mouth and back in that way. The ramp just isn't that attractive to me for wanting to go south. Well, that wraps up another ramp review. Thank you for watching the video. I do hope you've got something out of it. If you'd like to see more of my videos, you can go to my YouTube channel and also have a Facebook page. There's a link to that down in the video description. There'll be more videos coming. I try to post at least one a fortnight and often do better than that. Until next time, good fishing.